Okay, welcome to our next video in the Zapier automation series. So today we're going to go through what it takes to set up your first Zap. And we're going to try and make all of these tutorials useful and interesting and contain content that you can implement in your business and for yourself and hopefully can provide value immediately. So in this case, we're going to create a automation relating to survey responses or form responses that you might receive. So you can see the first here, the popular Zap that Zapier has selected here or suggested is to track new survey responses and alert team by email. So we're basically going to create this, a very similar Zap to this from scratch. And so to begin with, we need to go to Google Drive and we'll create a form in Google Drive. So Zapier, it's not just about creating Zaps in Zapier. It's also about understanding the automation and the platforms around that connect in with Zapier as well. But Zapier is just a connector and allows you to create workflows, but it needs to integrate usually with other online apps and software that you might be using. So in this case, we're going to create a form, very simple form just to illustrate. So go to Google Forms in Google Drive, and we'll call this form New customer. Close this. There we go. New customer info. And this is just to illustrate. So it's going to be very simple. But we've got customer name. Okay. Customer email. Customer phone number. Done. So we can have a look at how this form looks. Okay, great. We'll call this new customer info. And then we'll complete the form. So there's one example. So our Zap has something to refer to. So let me just add my details here. So then we go back into the Zapier and let's make a Zap. So we're going to go Google Sheets. Let's go Google Forms. And then when it creates Google Form, we're going to create an email. Very simple Zap. Okay. So as you can see here, this is the Zap workflow editor. And we can see that this is the new editor that's only just been released August 2019. And so this is quite a new feature. They're aiming to make it a little bit more user-friendly and a little bit faster and easier to update and edit and create your Zaps. So hopefully we'll find that's the case. It's broken up into sections and you can see the first one here is the trigger. So this is the starting point for Zapier and the first thing that you need to set up for a Zap. There needs to be something that happens in order to trigger the rest of the workflow. So in this case, we can see here that we've got a Google Form. So when the Google Form is, let's say there's a new response in the spreadsheet, then it triggers the Zap. So I've selected the app as Google Forms, and then I've selected the trigger event, which is new response in spreadsheet. I've got to set up the connection to my account. Okay. And then now it's connected up. I can continue. And then let's customize the response. So that means we're selecting which spreadsheet and then which worksheet that it's going to select from for this Zap. Trigger. And then the first thing we need to do once we have all that set up is to test. And you have to do that at each stage. And then we can see that the testing is complete. It worked. And it also pulls a sample of the first bit of data that you've got in that trigger. So in this case, we can see here, this is the date that it's happened. and then it's pulled in these values, the email address I added in, all the content of the form, and then broken down the phone number, the name there, so we can use these later in the, and then we can then create an email. So we do the same. Because this is the first time we've set this up, we're going to have to set up the Zapier so it knows that it's this particular Gmail account, the same as what we did for the Google Forms before. So first we'll select, we're going to send an email. So we've got to sign into Gmail there. We'll do the same again, where we just select, we've already logged into Gmail in another window, so we can just let Zapier know that it's approved their access. And then it connects it up and we select the right account. So there's only one in this Zapier account, so it's very easy. There's our Gmail, so we continue. And then we can create a customizer email. So for customizing, we add in where the email is going to go. So we want the email to come to us. So I'm going to add in my details here. If you want to have anyone CC'd on the email or be CC'd, who the email should come from. So in this case, we'll just use the same details here. But we'll use our, we've got to select from the drop down there. So we'll use that Gmail account, the from name, if you want to have. And reply to if it's different than the from name. Subject. So we can say new submission. That'll be on the subject. And then we can also add in additional details by including some of the custom information that's pulled in from that form. So in this case, we can add in a timestamp, and we could also say from, and then the person who has just registered. We'll say four. So then it's going to say new client submission four, and then the customer name, Tristan, and then timestamp. And this is in the subject. And then in the email, for the body of the email, you can either choose plain or HTML. Plain will just be text, and HTML, you can add in some simple HTML code as well to sort of format the email. So if you do plain, it'll just be text only, and so it will appear just as it seems on this screen. So we can do it like this. We can go, hello, here is the details of the form. And then we can put in this information. So we've got the customer name, we've got the email, we've got the phone number. And then because it's only going to appear with that information, we also will write it here. So there's a reference in the email for what this data is exactly. Great. And then we can also apply a certain label if we wish, based on your Gmail account here. And you can also add attachments if you have as well in that email, but that will be part of a later presentation. So that's that part, and then we can click continue. We're going to have to test again. So let's run the test. Great, Zap is ready. Let's check the results of the test. Here we go, new client submission for Tristan. So there's the name, here's the date and time. And then it has, hello, here are the details of the form, name, Tristan, email, here, phone number, here, done. So we've added all these details in. So it looks like it's working. So then let's turn this on. Great, now this will run all the time. Create our first Zap. Well done. So then let's do a test. Let's do a real test. So we fill in a form, john@gmail.com, phone number, new customer info. And then let's see if we can get an email. Okay, great. And there's the email, as you can see. So all the details have come through. Now this is Zap is turned on and everything is automatic. You see John, the email address, phone number, all mentioned there. And then if we go back to the Zap, the last thing we need to do is make sure that we've named the Zap. And it's important because as you create more and more Zaps, it's very easy to lose track of what is what. So usually I start with a number. And I like numbers as well as having a title that I can use. But it's up to you and your setup for how you want to have your naming convention. But it's important that you have rules that you usually follow. So I like to go with, in this case, we can say it's Google Form, new client submission. And so we're describing where it comes from and then where it's going to go to. We can also change that around a little bit and go with new client submission as a description of, and then what's actually the containing within the form. So the G, it's a Google form, and then it's going through to Gmail. And then the last thing we need to do is create a folder and organize. Usually I like to organize my Zaps under the stage that it comes through in terms of the process. So in this case, we have a new clients. We set up as new clients, and we put the Zap inside that new clients folder.
Great. So we have our first Zap. Well done. Congratulations. I hope you've been able to follow along. And share your feedback and questions in the comments below. And we hope we can prepare, you know, the answers and maybe future Zaps and informational videos to help you in setting these up. So there'll be a lot more coming through over the coming weeks. And we really look forward to engaging more with you and hopefully helping you build your Zap and automation stack. So let us know any feedback and thoughts. Okay, look forward to hearing from you. And also don't forget to subscribe to the YouTube channel as well and follow us on our other channels too. So look forward to connecting. Thank you. Bye.